Did some dinosaurs chew? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. So did dinosaurs really chew, munching down on their food and moving their jaws back and forth and chewing like a cow? Well, we've been looking at basal ornithischians. And the group became distinct from other dinosaurs in their ability to process food by chewing. Now, the earliest ornithischians were omnivores, with a diet of meat with the occasional salad on the side. But as they got bigger, they became more specialized vegetarians. Now, meat eaters just need to slice their food, and having sharp, scissor-like teeth is the best way to ingest meat. While plant eaters, they need to grind their food into smaller and smaller pieces because it takes longer to digest plant food than meat in the stomach and intestines. Now, plant-eating animals that don't grind their food with their teeth must have enlarged digestive tracts or big bellies to help further grind and digest their food inside their bodies. But ornithischians were the first dinosaur group to begin chewing and grinding their food, especially as they became more adapted to eating plants. Heterodontosaurus from the early Jurassic were the first dinosaurs to show this grinding feature in their teeth. Now, this grinding of the upper and lower teeth together is called occlusion. Now, early dinosaurs lacked any occlusion. The teeth were jagged, and they wouldn't match up when the teeth closed. But the early ornithischians developed the ability to grind their food between the occlusion of the upper and lower teeth. Yet they also retained the ability to continue to replace their teeth. And they did this by angling their upper teeth inward and their lower teeth outward, so they worked a bit like a cheese shredder to maximize that grinding surface. Now, the front teeth, they didn't have to be part of this chewing of the food. Rather, the front teeth were specialized for nipping and clipping off shoots and vegetation. The space between the nipping front teeth and the back chewing teeth is called a diastema. And many ornithischian dinosaurs had a well-developed diastema. Many other plant-eating animals, like horses and rabbits and camels and mice, have this arrangement of chewing teeth in the back and nipping teeth in front. Animals that chew also tend to have an enlarged carotid process. This is the region shaded in black. This is where the jaw muscles for closing the jaw attach to. Now, having strong, mobile jaw muscles aids in chewing vegetation. Not all ornithischians had nipping teeth in front. In fact, many had a beak structure called a rhamphatheca, which in life was covered by keratin. This is the same material that's on your fingernails. Now, rhamphatheca was supported by the predentary bone in the lower jaw in ornithischian dinosaurs. Now, this beak structure helped ornithischians to clip off vegetation and was likely much more effective than having narrow front teeth. Now, dinosaurs didn't have lips. This is a trait that's only found in mammals, which use our lips. We use our lips to suckle milk when we're infants. But did dinosaurs really have cheeks? Now, most ornithischians, there's an indentation along the chewing back teeth in the jaw, and this indentation is a unique trait for a large group of ornithischian dinosaurs that we call the genosauria. Now, many dinosaur paleontologists have struggled with how well formed this cheek was in life, especially when trying to reconstruct one of these dinosaurs and illustrating it. Now, we can add jaw muscles based on the muscle scars in the skull and jaw. But in doing so, we realized that the cheeks actually lacked any muscles. All the action of closing the jaw was in the back or interior of the jaw and the skull. Now, this indentation alongside the chewing teeth was likely covered by a fleshy skin, a bit like what's seen in living vultures. Now, this fleshy skin would prevent the food from falling outside of the mouth when it was chewing, and likely expanded as early ornithischian dinosaurs became more specialized vegetarians. Now, during the Cretaceous, the ornithischian dinosaurs became masters at chewing by developing rows of teeth which formed large tooth batteries. This allowed the teeth a much larger surface area to chew and process food, and was a major breakthrough in the evolution of plant-eating dinosaurs. Now, thousands of fossil teeth of ornithischian dinosaurs are known in the fossil record, especially in the Cretaceous, because like shark teeth, they were lost continuously throughout the life of the dinosaur. Now, because of this continual replacement of the teeth, dinosaurs never had to worry about wearing out their teeth. A new one would always grow in. Now, this is a pretty amazing adaptation for dinosaurs. All right, be sure to review the unique anatomy of ornithischian jaws and be able to explain the mastication, the chewing process, and how it differs from other dinosaurs that are specialized in eating meat.